Hey guys, it's Margaret. Today, I'm gonna show you guys how to take all of your bullet journaling skills and turn those into holiday cards. Holiday season is pretty much in full swing at this point, and there's nothing somebody appreciates more than a homemade card. So I'm gonna show you guys 10 different ways that you can use your skills to beautify just plain old cards. Nothing gets me in the holiday spirit like seeing lights. I absolutely love all of the beautiful decorations and the lights strung all over the trees. It makes me feel very warm and fuzzy. For this card, I'm gonna write "Have a bright holiday." So I began by writing "Have a" in an Art Deco style font towards the top of the card. And then I wrote "bright" in a bold script font towards the middle of the card, and finished off this saying with "holiday" in an Art Deco style font towards the bottom of the card. To accessorize this card, I drew two strings of lights by drawing two black lines behind the words and added colorful lights using pink, green, and blue markers. I also added little dashes coming from the word "bright" to make it seem like it was glowing. A trick I use to make things look like they're shining or glowing in my bullet journal, and I'm gonna use them on these cards, is to have dashes coming from a word or whatever you wanna make look like it's shining. For the envelope for this card, I'm going to take the string of lights that I used on the card and transfer those to this envelope. So I'm going to draw two strings of lights going across the envelope, but making sure not to cover the areas where the address will go and where the return address will go. I'm sure it's everyone's dream to have that fairy tale moment where the mistletoe is hanging and you get your kiss from your significant other or whoever you're dreaming of getting a kiss from. Well, hint, hint, this card is gonna be perfect for you. For this card, I'm going to give it a scalloped edge. So I took a pencil and lightly sketched out a scalloped edge around the card and cut along the edge of the card. Erase any of the extra markings from the sketching. Trace your sketch with a black micron and then color the berries in yellow, the leaves in green, and the bow in pink. At the bottom of the page, we're gonna write in small letters, hint, hint. For the envelope for this card, we're also gonna write a cute little message, but this time in the bottom left corner, we're going to write wink, wink, and draw a small sprig of mistletoe above that. I might be the only one that thinks this, but it's never too early for me to listen to holiday music. I love when it comes on the radio. It's my favorite time of the year. So I had to bring it into this card. This card, I'm going to feature jingle bells, and I'm also going to use a really cool candy cane washi tape. First, I took the candy cane washi tape and placed it diagonally on the top and bottom of the card. Towards the top of the middle section, I wrote jingle bells in a tall, skinny font. Below that, I wrote jingle all the way in a bold script font. For the envelope, I placed washi tape diagonally in the bottom left corner of the envelope the same way I did on the card. Washi tape is great because it's really easy to stick on and it immediately gives your card an extra added wow factor. One of my favorite memories back home in Wisconsin is building snowmen. Me and my siblings would spend hours getting the perfect snowman just right. So for this card, I'm going to incorporate a snowman snow globe and use the words "let it snow." To begin, I took a light blue cardstock and I cut the shape of a snow globe out of it. The shape of a snow globe is basically just a circle with a square bottom. On the base of the snow globe, I added several vertical dashes to give it some texture. I'm then gonna take whiteout and create a snowman and a pile of snow, making sure to leave space between the first and second snowballs. Then I gave the snowman a top hat, scarf, arms, buttons, and a face. You can either just stick the snow globe right onto your card, or you can use what's called foam squares, and you can get those at any local stationery or arts and crafts store. Foam squares are great because they actually lift up the paper, giving your card an extra added dimension. Then I wrote the word "snow" vertically with big bubble letters and gave each letter a drop shadow. I wrote "let it" in the empty space towards the top left of the card in a script font. I then colored in the letters using a light blue marker. For the envelope, I simply drew a top hat and scarf in the bottom left corner. I love a good excuse to drink hot chocolate every day, and the winter season gives me just that. So I wanted to dedicate an entire card to my love of hot chocolate. The first thing I'm gonna do on this card is draw two mugs of hot chocolate. To do this, I drew one tall mug and one pear-shaped mug and gave both faces. In the tall mug on the left, I drew whipped cream and some cinnamon sticks. In the pear-shaped mug on the right, I drew a couple marshmallows and a candy cane. I'm personally more of a marshmallow girl. I've never really loved whipped cream, so I'm definitely going to have a glass of hot chocolate after this. Once I'm done drawing both doodles, I colored them in. In the space at the top, I'm going to write "Happy Hot Chocolate Season." I wrote the word happy in a wide Art Deco style font. I wrote hot chocolate in a tall Art Deco style font, and I wrote season in a wide Art Deco style font. This card is the best if you have any friends who are hot chocolate fanatics. I know my best friend is absolutely obsessed with hot chocolate, so she's getting this card this year. On the envelope for this card, I drew marshmallows and splatters of hot chocolate in the bottom left. This next card is going to feature the words "Joy to the World," and let me tell you, as I was planning out all of these cards, my boyfriend was absolutely sick of me. I was singing holiday songs like crazy. I could not get them out of my head. To begin, I took washi tape that had an abstract pattern and put it all along the border of the card. In the center of the card, I wrote the words "Joy to the World." I wrote the words "Joy and World" larger than the words "to" and "the," and added little bursts coming from the center of the card. I then gave the words "Joy and World" a drop shadow with a green and red marker. The envelope for this card is super easy. All I did was add a strip of the same washi tape to the bottom of the envelope. When the holiday season is all over, it's the beginning of a new year. And whenever I think of the new year, I only think of silver and gold, which is exactly what's going to be featured in this card. To begin, I wrote the word "hello" in the large script font and gave each letter a silver highlight. Then I wrote 2019 in large Art Deco style letters and put bursts on either side of 2019. I used silver and gold glitter glue to make fireworks all across the card. Make sure that you allow this card to fully dry before you put it inside the envelope, otherwise you risk getting glitter glue everywhere. On the envelope of this card, put a few glitter glue fireworks at the bottom left of the envelope. Washi tape is great for so many reasons, but oftentimes I find that people really only use it for borders or for dividers. But in this card, I'm actually gonna show you guys how to take washi tape and make them into gift boxes. For this card, I took several different kinds of washi tape and cut them into different sizes to make gift boxes. I stacked the washi tape on top of each other to look like a pile of gifts, and then gave each gift a little bow at the top. At the very top of the card, I wrote "Happy Holidays" in a large, bold script font above all of the pile of gifts. I gave each word an underline. For the envelope, I'm going to make a few more gifts and put them in the bottom left corner. Tis the season of the ugly sweater, which I love. So I really wanted to create a card where I could make the ugly sweater of my dreams. I could put whatever pattern I want on that ugly sweater. If you're not into doodling or you don't want to draw an ugly sweater, I'm sure you can find several images online of all different types of ugly sweaters and you can just paste that right on top. First, I sketched a large ugly sweater towards the top of my card using several different patterns throughout the sweater. I used evergreen trees, candy canes, snowflakes, and abstract patterns to decorate my ugly sweater. I traced the sketch with a black micron and then colored the sweater in using red, green, pink, and blue. Towards the bottom, I wrote "May all your sweaters be" in a tall, skinny font and wrote "Ugly and Bright" in a bold, skinny font below that. On the envelope, I drew a pattern from the ugly sweater at the bottom of the envelope. As a kid, making snowflakes was always so exciting, and it kind of still is for me, because you fold up that paper, you make all sorts of cuts, and have no idea what it's gonna look like when you unfold it. So I want an entire card where I get to make tiny little snowflakes. To begin, I wrote "Season's Greetings" in large Art Deco style font at the top of the card. To make snowflakes, I used blue paper, folded it up, and made cutouts all throughout the paper. When I open up the folded blue paper, I have a tiny snowflake. You can either paste this to the card or use foam squares. To add a little dimension to the snowflakes, you can take white out and add little white dots to the snowflakes. On the envelope, I added a snowflake in the bottom left corner, but instead of using a foam square, I used a glue stick to stick it on for fear that it might fall off while in transit. I know all of my family and friends are gonna absolutely love these cards, and I really hope that you got inspired to make your own cards for your family and friends. Comment below which was your favorite card, and before you go, make sure you subscribe to 17's YouTube channel so that you don't miss out on any of our future bullet journaling tips and tricks. Happy holidays and see you next week.